Hey, I'm here to talk about GreaseMonkey. In this 5 minutes video, we will see what is GreaseMonkey, an example of how I used it on an existing website, and the basics about Userscript development. Hopefully, it will help you to develop your first Userscript. What is GreaseMonkey? GreaseMonkey allows the modification of a web page on the fly with a JavaScript. This is a great tool to add features to a website or modify it when you have no control on it. When the page is loaded, the GreaseMonkey script or user script is executed and alters the rendered page. Let's take as example a user script I developed. Here is a website I do not own but that I use regularly. It is the website of my boat club. To reserve a boat, I need to go through this calendar one time for the boats available in the morning and one time for the boats available in the afternoon. It is pretty cumbersome and it can be very time consuming to find the boat I want. So I decided to write a Userscript to improve the site. I would like to add a link here, and when I click on it, display the list of boats available. So here's the user script I wrote. I can take it and drag and drop it in the browser here at Chrome. I install it. I can see it has been installed. And the next time I browse the website, the page will be modified. So let's log in. I can see the new link added by the script. When I click on it, I see a table with the list of boats available. Here's the days of the week and the list of the boats. A boat available in the afternoon and the morning. I can also click on the button next week and see what boats are available in the next week. Let's now look at the user script. It is basically a standard JavaScript file with the extension .user.js. Let's edit it. We see it starts with a header and there is a tag userscript. There are some attributes. Name is the name of the userscript. Description is the description as it appears during the installation. Include is very important as it defines in which pages the script is executed. Star means on every pages of the website. You can also define copyright version and license. Then we see the constants that are used in the user script and all the functions that are called. And finally, the first function call is the entry point of the user script. So let's look at this first function. On the first line here, I find the element in which I will insert the new link. Here I create the link and here I insert it. Let's see how I find in which element I want to insert the link. To do that, I use Firebug, which is an extension for Firefox. And I inspect the links of the menu and I realize that they all have the same class name. So I'm gonna use this class name to find this element. And I will find the third element and find its parents, and is where I insert the link. Let's see the corresponding code. So I get the elements for the class menu item, take the third item, and get the parent. Now I would like to show you how to set up an onClick event on an element. I use addEventListener with the parameter onClick and the function to be called. You need to use that instead of setting directly onClick because it's not working with GreaseMonkey. Now I will capture the HTTP request sent by the original page to retrieve the list of boats available this half day. So here's the request. This is the data sent to the server. And this is the server response. It's basically some HTML code. And this code is used to display the list. Yeah. now that I captured the HTTP request to retrieve the list of available boats, I can build one dynamically and send it from my user script using Ajax. There is something particular about GreaseMonkey here that I would like to point out. It is the way you need to set the parameter onReleased and change. In a regular JavaScript, you could just reference the function to be called, but GreaseMonkey anonymizes all the functions in the user script, and it is made to avoid name collisions with the function in the original pages. In the JavaScript context visible by the page, the function requestCallback won't be visible. And this is why you need to set this parameter as I did here, defining a reference to an anonymous function. The page added by my user script is using two images. As I didn't want to depend on an external website, I embedded them directly in my JavaScript code. To do that, in your image tag, you can set the source attribute to the base64 conversion of your image. There are many websites on the internet that can help you to do this conversion. If you are constantly annoyed by a poorly designed website, you will now have the opportunity to try GreaseMonkey and fix it.